The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. As Jesus was speaking, a woman in the crowd raised her voice and said, "Happy the womb that bore you and the breasts you sucked." But he replied, "Still happier those who hear the word of God and keep it." One day, while Jesus was preaching to the crowd, there was that woman who shouted out in that short gospel. She watched him very carefully, and as she watched him, she obviously became very excited by what she heard. And that's why she shouted out, "Blessed is the womb that bore you." It was an impressive testimony from one woman to another. And although the woman presumably did not know Mary of Nazareth, the evidence was before her, because for her, whoever Mary was, she must have been some woman at the testimony that Jesus was giving before her. It's also great evidence to us of the bonding of human life, the ties that bind us together, the ties of blood and knowledge and affection and faith. Nobody is an isolated individual. It all began for us in the person of our mother. Everybody's origins are in one's mother. Every human being's origins are in their mother. That's where we started out on our journeys of human life. And it was in the womb of our mother, that we began to grow and experience nourishment and warmth and security and belonging. And it began unconsciously there in the darkness of the womb. When we are born, the growth of our life then begins in our mother's arms. And the person that we grow up to be depends on that powerful influence, our mother. Therefore, I would like to think that a mother is a holy place, because that is where life begins and love begins for every human being. That's why the woman in the crowd shouted out, "Blessed is the womb that bore you." And like that woman in the crowd, we don't know an awful lot about Mary. But like the woman in the crowd, we know an awful lot from her son of what a woman she was. The things we know of Jesus point back to his origins, his birth, his home, his atmosphere, all tell us something about his mother. They tell us that she was a real person. She had a real life in a real world. She wasn't just a plastic statue. Because we have a teaching that Mary was without sin, we can so often see her as someone that we cannot relate to. But to be human does not mean that we have to be sinful. Mary was free from sin and therefore born free from the contamination of sin and malice. And into that freedom, Jesus was born and grew up. One of the most important things about being a mother is learning to let our children go. We have to allow children to have freedom in order that they might continue to love and leave our parents and return in a different way. And we are told that Jesus left his home, and that is to the credit of Mary. The freedom of Jesus to go out and become a grown-up in a grown-up world was due to his mother. We all need to leave our parents so that we can love them in an adult way. Mary was able to let her son go, and as a result, their love was to grow greater, not less. Perhaps the greatest witness of Mary is in the last pages of the Gospel. By the cross of Jesus, it says, stood Mary, his mother. There can be no worse suffering, I can imagine, than watching somebody you love suffer and die. She too was crucified with him in standing by him. She wanted to do something, but could do nothing. And we all know that experience of our children, of being able to do nothing and saying nothing. That was the faithfulness of Mary, which was with her throughout her life, was with her until she was assumed body and soul into heaven. And it was shortly after the death of Jesus and Mary that Christians began to remind themselves in painting pictures of Mary, and eventually statues, that we keep her in mind, who is so dear to us. It's the tradition in every Catholic church that we have a crucifix and an altar, and not far away, a statue of Mary. We have always kept her in our hearts. Today, she's at the heart of the church because she is a lay person, a faithful person, and a holy person, as we should be, the heart of the church. A few years ago, Paul McCartney wrote a song. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And all the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. That's how Mary lived her life. There will be an answer, let it be. Today, we pray for all mothers to Our Lady, because every mother is a holy place, and we must cherish our mothers. And today especially, we pray for all broken-hearted mothers, that they may be healed, or like Mary, like that song, they may learn to say, let it be.